What up, guys? JP back at you once again, bringing you guys another DVD slash Blu-ray slash VHS slash book update. And guys, I gotta say, in like 2 or 3 weeks, all of a sudden, this stack that I've had that was pretty big turned into a massive stack. I just got a ton of stuff in all at once, so I figured it is time to make a DVD update. It's been a little while, so with that said, let's jump into this baby. First up, I want to show a book that I picked up, and I picked this up at Goodwill. Been doing a lot of Goodwill hunting lately for VHS, and I came across this book. It is Psycho 2. Now, back in the 80s especially, and even nowadays, they did novelizations, which was basically a book version of the movie. The movie would come out, an author would be tasked with writing a book version of the movie, usually based off of the script. Sometimes you get details that were left out of the movie. This is not that, and I thought it was at first. I figured this was just a novelization of Psycho 2. But it's actually its own story. The author of the original Psycho book wrote a sequel to that that I guess is different from the Psycho 2 movie, which got me super intrigued. I read a tiny little snippet of this, and from what I understand, it begins with Norman Bates escaping a mental hospital, unlike the movie where he was released. So I am very curious to see where this goes. It's like finding an alternate timeline to Psycho. This should be really interesting. Goodwill has a bunch of cool stuff every once in a while, and I immediately caught my eye. I don't spend much time in the book section, but that caught my eye. Next up, I want to show some VHSs. Some of them are non-horror, so just bear with me. I know most of you guys are on my channel for horror, but this was really cheap, so I decided to go with it. It is the Adventures of Indiana Jones. This is the 3 Indiana Jones films. We have The Last Crusade, Raiders of the Lost Ark, and Temple of Doom, all on VHS here, which I actually have never seen a single Indiana Jones film, and I'm actually curious to check them out one day. I probably will never get to this box set simply because I would have to run out of stuff to watch, and that is not happening anytime in the next couple years, but maybe one day I'll find a reason to watch these. And you know, it was a dollar. I just couldn't not get it for some reason. And I was wondering if you guys know this, on the spines here, it says chapter 23, 24, and 25 of the Complete Adventures of Indiana Jones. I don't understand what that means. From what I understand, there's only these 3 original movies and then a 4th one that was made in, you know, recent times. So I don't understand what these chapters are for. Were these books before and they just picked like 3 random Indiana Jones stories? Like, I don't understand. If anybody knows what that means, please drop me a comment to kind of explain it to me. After that, this is a huge bite of nostalgia. It is Back to the Future. I realized that I see these all the time at Goodwill, Back to the Futures, and I never pick them up. And then I was like, dude, Back to the Future is literally like my second favorite non-horror film of all time, and I don't own it on DVD or Blu-ray, so the only way I can watch it is I have all 3 of them recorded on DVR from over the years, and I do watch them a lot. You know, if I'm tired and trying to fall asleep or something, and there's nothing on, I'll throw on a Back to the Future and go to sleep to it because I love these films. So I figured I need to own these, and I figured I might as well own them on VHS. So I grabbed the first Back to the Future. Very nostalgic for me. I love that film. And a couple days later, just a few days after I bought that one, I went back to that same Goodwill, and they had Back to the Future 2. So I picked it up. I couldn't not pick it up. Back to the Future 2. Love that one. I love Back to the Future 3 as well, but I have not ran into that one yet, so maybe sometime in the future. And this next one here is a huge bite of nostalgia for me. I recently was watching one of Jesse Midnight Crawler's videos. Check the link in the description below for his channel. He's lately been doing a lot of VHS pickups as well, a lot of VHS hunting, which I thought was super cool. It seems like there's a few YouTubers and even in the horror community on Facebook have been going out and hunting for VHS lately. I think that's really cool. I don't know where it really started. I don't know why I started doing it. I don't know if I seen somebody do it and then I was like, oh, or just, you know, coincidence, whatever, but I love to see everybody kind of doing this now. And I seen that Jesse picked up this tape in one of his recent videos, and it is The Land Before Time. And this film is very nostalgic for me. I remember This was on constant rotation in my VHS player when I was a kid, my VCR. And I would always watch like this and then like Friday the 13th Part 5 or Nightmare on Elm Street Part 2 or something. I know it's very bizarre, but I had a really bizarre childhood. I didn't have any restrictions on the horror movies I could watch. So even as a young ass kid, you know, like 3 or 4, I'd pop this in and then an Elm Street film or something like that. But I always rotated back to Land Before Time and An American Tale, Five Will Goes West. Those were kind of my two cartoon movies that I always watched. And this is actually the same version of the Land Before Time that I had when I was a kid. And I believe it's the same one that's in Jesse's video with the blue border and the awesome, you know, artwork there on the original cover there. And you know, I will watch this because it is a movie that I'm very nostalgic for, and I haven't seen it in a very long time, but I do remember it being quite depressing. After that, a little bit of horror here. You know, I don't know why I picked this up. Sometimes I go to Goodwill, and if I don't see anything, I'll just settle with something. Usually, the closest thing to horror. And this was the closest thing to horror. It is horror, but it is Halloween Resurrection. There's no reason to own this on VHS. Absolutely no reason. It's a bad movie. It wasn't even made in the 80s or 90s. It is a... Was it? No, 2002, I think. Yeah, in... There's no reason to have this. It's not retro. There's no reason to have this on VHS. But I don't know, man. It was sealed, and that kind of sold it for me, I guess. That's why I convinced myself, like, oh, it's sealed. Maybe I'll pick it up or whatever, and it'll stay next to my other Halloween VHS or whatever. And, man, I don't know. I think I only paid a dollar for it, but that's a dollar too much because this movie is not good. But it is sealed, and it's in good condition. I don't own any sealed VHS, I don't think so. I thought that was kind of cool, I guess. After that, we have Frankenstein, the original Frankenstein. And I own this film on Blu-ray and DVD. Why not own it on VHS? I actually am a huge fan of this line that they did back in the day, the Universal, or the Classic Collection line, where all these covers are kind of the same and have the border and stuff. I always thought it'd be cool if I owned all of those. I would never do that, but if I see any of them on VHS for $1.58, I'm going to pick them up. You know, I've seen most of these Universal Classic films, and it's kind of cool to own things on VHS. You know, I just got the bug lately, and I've just been feeling it. After that, we have Crash and Burn. This is a Full Moon Paramount release here. I picked it up because it's a Full Moon. It's more like action-oriented, it looks like, but I love Full Moon, so I will check this out eventually. And these are the tapes that I'm typically looking for, like the retro, a little bit more obscure ones. It's not super obscure or anything. I'm sure that you can find this film on DVD or something like that, but I just never heard of it, so that's why I picked it up. But you don't always find that, but sometimes you do, like this one, Dinosaurs. I don't know what this is. It's from the 50s, I believe, and it's black and white, and it's about dinosaurs, so what the hell, you know? That's kind of what I'm mainly looking for, but I usually settle on whatever they have if they don't have anything cool. After that, House on Haunted Hill. I'm sure you can get this anywhere. It's in the public domain, but I just like the cover, so I decided to grab it. After that, this is another one of those like Alien or Halloween Resurrection type things. Hellraiser 4 Bloodline. There's no reason to own this on VHS, but for whatever reason, I just bought it. I don't know, man. Whatever. I don't even like Hellraiser 4 that much, besides the opening to it, you know, some of the flashback period piece stuff, but I don't know. The cover reminded me of when I was a kid, so I picked it up. After that, these are two that I got from a friend here for my birthday, which I thought was really cool. My friend Carly, I'll leave her, she recently started a YouTube channel, so I'll leave her link in the channel description. The video description. I'll leave her channel in the video description below. Jesus Christ, I can't talk. Sorry, guys. But she got me Friday the 13th Part 4, the final chapter, on VHS, as well as Friday the 13th Part 8, Jason Goes to Hell, on VHS. These are actually the only two Friday the 13ths that I do not own on VHS, so I was very happy to finally receive these because now my original... Let me take that back. The original Paramount line, these are the only two that I didn't have. So Friday the 13th, 1 through 8, I didn't own on VHS. But now I do, so that's really cool. I didn't own these two, and now I own all 8, so that's really neat. And the final two VHS here, I grabbed at a different like sort of thrift store. They had a wall of VHS, and behind those VHS was more VHS, but unfortunately, there was not a lot of horror. It was mainly like Alien and like Silence of the Lambs and like Scream, stuff like that, you know, run-of-the-mill stuff. And they had actually I think a Godzilla tape and a Universal Monster, but the tape was in rough condition, so I passed on it. But they did have one cool thing, and it was The Voyage of Sinbad, which I thought was pretty cool. Ray Harryhausen. I've actually seen, I think, one of the Sinbad movies before, but I can't really remember which one it was. I'll revisit this because I really dig Ray Harryhausen's stuff, and that's like the perfect type of movie to have on VHS. And after that, we have The Valley of Gwangi, which, I don't know how to say that, but it's like cowboys versus dinosaurs, man. Like, you gotta pick that up. Like, I believe this is a Warner Archive title that you can get, and that's like sort of their manufacturer on demand label, which is just way too pricey for me, so I don't even own a single one of them, I don't think. And this is a good way to own this film that I will not pay for on the Warner Archive label, so had to pick that up as well. And that's all for the VHS, guys. Let's move on into the DVDs. First up, I want to say that I got a few non-horror things here. I'm just going to show them all at once because it'll be a pain in the ass and make the video long if I showed each individual DVD. And, you know, so this is a simple way. So I got Weeds, the complete series here. We have Weeds Season 1 through 8 on DVD for $14.99 at Goodwill there. I couldn't pass it up, man. These were all rubber band together. They were in decent condition. They didn't seem like they were in a house that, you know, people just didn't care about the DVDs. The discs are in good condition. So I was like, you know what? How often can you get an entire complete series of something that is 8 seasons long for $15? My answer was not very often, so I decided to pick them up. I've seen actually all of these episodes. I've seen every single episode of Weeds. It was actually one of the first shows that I got into in like terms of modern shows, and I followed it throughout its course. And you know, it was started off really strong. First two seasons are great, and then it's like up and down and up and down. And I think by the final season, I was pretty content with how the show ended. But one day I will revisit this show. Probably not anytime soon because it's only been a couple years since I finished it. But I've always liked this show. It's a really cool concept, great characters, stuff like that. So that is Weeds, the complete series on DVD. I couldn't pass it up. After that, this was the other gift that my friend got me for my birthday, and it is Friday the 13th, the series, the complete series, that is. It has all three seasons. This is something that I wanted for a very long time, but I just didn't want to pay for it back when they were released originally, and then when they had the re-release, and I think this is the third release from this show. So it was really cool, my friend, to actually hook me up with this, because it's something that I probably wouldn't have paid for anytime soon unless I saw it super cheap. But now I don't have to pay for it, and I got it for free, and it was a pretty cool birthday gift. So again, shout out to Carly, link in the description down below. Check out her channel, guys. She's just starting out, she's doing some cool videos and stuff, so give her a sub if you guys would. After that, we have the Jess Franco collection coming to us courtesy of Umbrella Entertainment. And this collection here has Eugene, 99 Woman, Venus and Furs, Vampiros, Lesbos, and She Killed in Ecstasy. So you got some sleazy / cheesy Jess Franco here. I only watched one film out of this so far. I watched Eugene. It was okay. It was pretty sleazy, but it was a little boring at times. Wasn't my favorite film in the world, but I'm curious to see what else he has to offer. I don't mind his films too much. I know that they're a little bad and stuff, but whatever, you know. It's cool in my book. You guys can grab this from Umbrella. This is a region-free DVD here, even though it does say, it does say region all on the back, so yeah, you guys can pick that up. After that, we have Child Eater. This one's coming from MVD. I did watch this. It was decent. It wasn't amazing or anything, but definitely pretty solid. Way better than I was expecting. There's actually like a few creepy moments in it. Like actually genuinely like, you know, scary type, scares. And, you know, for a title, Child Eater, it has a lot to live up to. You know, that sounds terrifying, you know, if you play your cards right, you can make a really scary movie, you know, called Child Eater. But it's all right, it's not bad. I recommend it. After that, we have another title from Umbrella Entertainment here. We have Sugar Mountain. This is a flick that was actually pretty good. I highly recommend checking this out. I did a review on it for the 31 Days of Horror that I was really late on. It's more of a thriller, it's not really a horror film, but there's like tons of twists in it, and it has like a cool story, actually. A bunch of people go up into like the Alaskan mountains and pretend to be lost so that they can sell their story, but it kind of backfires and stuff. It's actually a really neat movie. After that, we have Akira, which is an anime. I didn't think I would ever pick up an anime, but everybody kept telling me to buy this shit, and it was $5 at Walmart, so I was like, whatever, I'll grab it. So I did pick it up, and I don't know when I'll ever watch this or whatever, but people have just been telling me that it's great, so maybe eventually. After that, we have another $5 pickup from Walmart. We have Duel. I've actually never seen this. This is a Steven Spielberg film. I guess it's more along the lines of a thriller, but I've always wanted to see it. It's one that I know a little bit about. I hear people talk about it all the time, but I've actually never seen it. So that's a title that I've been wanting in the collection for a little while now. After that, I actually bought these from the UK when I did my last UK order. And I grabbed the Amityville Curse, which I think is the fifth Amityville. I'm not 100% sure on that, guys. But yeah, this one is the Amityville Curse. And I don't know much about it, but it's one that I didn't have. I think this is actually the one that does not have a release in the U.S., but I did buy this. I think it is all region, so that's pretty cool. It's used, but I got it for pretty cheap on Amazon UK, so I'm not complaining. And after that, we have Amityville Dollhouse, which this is not the version that I ordered. They sent me what I believe is like the French version or Italian version or something like that. All of it is in another, I guess it's the Italian version, but apparently it does have the English track. It goddamn better have the English track or I'm gonna be mad because I did spend about $8 on this. So that is the Amityville Dollhouse. I have seen this film. I actually like it. It's one of the better Amityvilles in the terms of... Actually, it's just one of the better Amityvilles. Like, I would go Amityville 1, 2, then this one. But I haven't seen them all, so I can't say too much about that. After that, I picked this up from Target a while back. Had a buy two get one free sale, and I took advantage of it and bought a few things. And this was one of the titles that I grabbed. It is the Coffin Joe Trilogy. For the longest time, I thought these films were going to be all released on Blu-ray, but apparently that kind of fell through. I guess they couldn't find good negatives to do the transfers, but the third one, which I just found out was made in 2008. I thought all three of these were made back in the 60s, so apparently the newest one was made in 08. That one is on Blu-ray, but the other two are only available on DVD. But I've always wanted to check out these films. I've heard nothing but good things. I hear they're great. I think they're going to be right up my alley, so I can't wait to check these out. Maybe we can cover them on the 22 Shots of Moods and Horror podcast one day. I think that would be a lot of fun. I know Moods would be down. After that, we have Monster in the Closet. I picked this up because we're covering the 1986 horror films on an upcoming podcast, episode 106, I believe. We're covering all horror films from 1986, as well as doing our top 10 of 1986. So I've been trying to pick up and watch every 1986 horror film that I can. Monster in the Closet by Troma. This will probably be like the third or fourth Troma I've watched from 1986. I'll get to it eventually. I'm actually kind of coming around on Troma. Talked a lot of shit on them for years, but even their bad movies are still kind of fun in a weird way, so I'm not even hating on that, guys. I'm not even hating on it. I know you expect me to, Moods, listening, but yeah, I'm not going to hate on that. After that, Andy... Crips the Homie. Check the link in the description for Andy's channel as well. So that's Jesse Midnight Crawler, Carly, and Andy. I'll put all three of their links in the description. Andy the Homie hooked me up with a copy of Neon Maniacs, which is also a 1986 film. And I've never actually seen this movie, but I've heard really good things about it. This is actually a Code Red, and I actually do not own a single Code Red. I actually don't like Code Red because of their business model and just the way that I've so many negative stories that I've heard about them. I never wanted to support them. From what I understand, they're kind of having a company turnaround where they're starting to do a little bit more respectable things. So I got to, you know, kind of cool it and see what they're doing now. But Andy tricked me into getting a Code Red by sending me this copy for free. But thank you, Andy. That's awesome, man. This is also 1986, so I do need to check this out. Thank you for hooking me up with a copy. And last up for the DVDs here, we have Sorority House Massacre, which is also 1986. I bought this off of eBay for $5. This guy was selling it for like $8 shipped, and he had a best offer thing, so I was like, hey, $5 shipped, and he accepted it. And it's actually in a nice little sleeve and stuff. I thought that was pretty cool. Really good condition, so every once in a while you do, you know, get a really good deal on eBay. So, yeah, this probably is similar to the Slumber Party Massacre, so I'm actually super down to check this out. So now let's move on to the Blu-rays. These next few Blu-rays I grabbed in the Target buy two get one free sale, which I really hope they do again because I picked up a lot of cool stuff. We have a Blue Underground release, the Killer Thrillers Collection, featuring Baba Yaga, Night Train Murders, and Strip Nude for Your Killer. These are really cool sets. They also put out the Dario Argento collection as well as the Lucio Fulci collection, which I own both, and I think those are the only three Blu-ray collections that Blue Underground has done, but I really like the concept and I hope they take some more of their back catalog and release them in triple packs, because it's a very affordable way to pick these films up. All three films are on individual discs, which is nice, and it saves on space, and for somebody who's becoming very limited on space, that's a good thing for me. I missed out on a ton of Blue Undergrounds when they were being released. I only owned, I think, like Zombie and maybe Maniac, and now I've finally been able to start picking up some of these Blue Undergrounds because they have such a fantastic library, but the price point was always too high for me, at least for the time. But now their price points are way lower. You can get them between like $10 and $15 and sometimes less during certain sales and stuff. So I'm going to start picking up more Blue Undergrounds. But I thought this was a good deal here, so really happy with that. Then I actually bought this because I thought it was released in 1986 to cover on the podcast, but it's actually 1987. It is the Synapse release of Street Trash. I've actually never seen this film, but I've always wanted to. This cover has always intrigued me, and I've never seen it. I remember when this got released, everybody was talking about it, and I just didn't pick it up, but now I finally have it, so I will eventually watch Street Trash. Seems like such a cool 80s film to own, so happy to have that. After that, I grabbed another Argento film. I grabbed the Synapse kind of standard version of Tenebrae. This film was released in that steelbook by Synapse, and I just completely thought it was overpriced and ridiculous. They said they weren't going to release a standalone edition. I knew they was lying. Of course, a couple months later, they released a standalone edition. I waited, bought the standalone edition, and very happy to have this. I've not seen this film from Dario Argento. There's actually a handful of films I've still yet to see, more than a handful, so I'm slowly but surely trying to collect all of his films, and I love Argento. So far, everything that I've seen, I've at least enjoyed, and there's some really, really good films in his library, so and to know that I'm not even halfway through his library really excites me. After that, this was another one that I picked up in that buy two, get one free. It is Intruder, another Synapse release, and I'm starting to knock off some of these titles that I've had on the wish list for years, and it's mostly a lot of Blue Undergrounds as well as Synapse releases, and Intruder is one that I've just wanted forever, but I could not find it for a decent price that I was willing to pay for the longest time. I'm a budget shopper. I like getting things for a couple dollars under what they typically go for. So I was finally able to do that, and Intruder, I hear it's one of the better slashers ever. I've never seen it, so I'm really excited to check it out. It's always been one that looked really cool to me, so glad to finally own Intruder on Blu-ray. After that, we got a few Vinegar Syndromes here. We have Hobgoblins. You know what? I remember seeing this as a kid, or at least seeing the like cover, and always remembering the cover, but I can't remember anything about the movie. I can't remember if I even seen it, but when I saw that Vinegar Syndrome was releasing this, I thought it was so cool, and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna pick this up. This is a cool release. Actually has a decent amount of special features on there, and Vinegar Syndrome I've really been digging lately, so I'm gonna keep buying their stuff because I really like their releases. So Hobgoblins, got that one in that sale as well as this film right here, which is Witch Trap, and this is another Vinegar Syndrome. I don't really know much about Witch Trap. I haven't ever seen it. I hear that it's kind of cheesy and stuff, but, you know, whatever. Vinegar Syndrome does fantastic transfers. I'm just really interested in the films that they're putting out right now, so whether they're good or bad, I'll find that out later. I just like their releases, so I'm going to grab them when I can get them for a deal. After that, we have a Vestron video release here. collector series, and we have The Gate. Absolutely love The Gate. The Gate is one of my favorite 80s horror films. I have not cracked this bad boy open yet. I'm kind of behind on editing my Vestron Video podcast, but eventually I will cover this release. It's a great movie. Can't wait to check it out on Blu-ray, and it is loaded with special features. And after that, this one was sent to me courtesy of Lionsgate and Vestron Video Collector Series. It is the Wishmaster Collection. I did a review on this, so if you're curious, check that out. It is in my past videos. Wishmaster 1, I actually really like it, even though it is kind of cheesy at times. I think it's a fantastic movie for its time. It's not the greatest in the world, but I just have fun with it. I really do. Wishmaster 2, same thing goes with that. The rules and plot holes are kind of all over the place, but I like it. Wishmaster 3, I didn't like so much. I didn't expect to like it, so it, no harm, no foul. But Wishmaster 4, I didn't expect to like it, and I actually thought it was pretty cool. So, you know, I like the Wishmaster films. I really do. They're cheesy. They're kind of bad, but I really enjoy them. This is a pretty cool release, too. A little bit pricey, but if you can find it for a good price, I do recommend it. You know, $7 a film, I think it's worth it for that. After that, this was another title that I believe I picked up. Where the hell did I pick this? I think I ordered this off. I can't remember. I might have ordered this off Amazon. But I bought this myself, and it is Miss 45. This is a title that I've been wanting forever, but I could not find it for a price that I wanted it for. It happens all the time. I'll see a film go for a price like $15, and then I won't buy it for whatever reason, low on cash at the time or whatever, but then I cannot buy that movie until I see it for that price or under again, because it just bugs me if I do, because it's like I could have got it for 15. And that's what took me so long with Miss 45. I seen it go on sale for 15 one time, and I was like, I'm not buying it until I can find it for 15 or under. Finally found it for a decent price. Miss 45, awesome, awesome, awesome. Awesome, awesome. I can't wait to check this out. Like, this is one that I've heard so much good things about. Rape revenge, nunsploitation, all the cool shit. So, really excited to check out Miss 45. And after that, we have another title. This one I picked up, I believe, off of Amazon for like $10 or something. It's Class of Nukem High. I watched this recently because it is a 1986 horror film, and I actually enjoyed it. Like, it's a pretty fun movie. It's ridiculous and cheesy and silly. It's supposed to be. It's Trauma. I don't really know what you can expect out of Trauma other than Trauma, so that's what I expected, that's what I got. It was fun, it was fine. I don't love these type of movies, but I have fun with them, so I did like Class of Nukem High. And next up, moving along here, we have, these are a couple of Arrow releases under their Arrow Academy branch of their company, which I don't know anything about. I think these are a mixture of like contemporary films mixed with like, I don't know anything about this label, but first up here we have Cinema Paradiso. All I know is it is like 174 minutes long, which is very long. Luchino Visconti's Ludwig, and this is like a box set with like two films in it. I'm not exactly sure if these are just supposed to be like art house films or what they are. This one was, holy shit, this one's 257 minutes. And then we have Property is No Longer Theft. Don't know much about it. I have not read the backs of these yet, so I'm kind of just showing them off. I'm sorry if that's kind of boring, guys. The Creeping Garden, this one actually sounded kind of cool. I think this even comes with a soundtrack, which is neat. But I like the cover to this, so this one actually looks a little interesting to me. We have The Story of Sin. After that, we have The Assassin. This one looks kind of cool, actually. Finally, for the Arrow Academy, we have Three Brothers. And then we have some Arrows that I definitely plan on checking out. First up, we have Django, Prepare a Coffin. I've always wanted to check out these old Django films, and Arrow recently is about to release this one, so definitely going to be something I watch. I'm going to watch this with my grandfather because he's like super into westerns, and seriously, like, the western channel is on all the time in our house, so I really want to check that out with him because, you know, he likes stuff like that. Good bonding moment. Psychomania, I actually watched this. I didn't do a review on it because I didn't really like it, and I didn't feel like I had much value to add to it. Maybe I need to watch it again. I just really wasn't in the mood for this type of movie. It was just kind of boring, and I just didn't really like it that much. But I hear there are fans of it. We are the Flesh. Expect a review of this really soon. That's all I'll say on it for now. After that, we have Dead or Alive, which this is the trilogy, the Takashi Miike trilogy. This is probably what I'm going to watch tonight, actually, at least the first one. I'm actually really curious on these films. I know they're not horror, at least I don't think they're horror. I think they're like action or something, but I don't know. They just kind of look a little neat, and I've heard good things about them, so I would check those out. And then these ones I just got in the mail today. We have, this is a film by Mario Bava and Ricardo Freda. It is Katiki the Immortal Monster. I have no idea what this is, but it's Bava, so that's a good sign. I definitely check this out. Looks like a little more up my alley, because Arrow's been releasing a lot of non-horror stuff lately, but especially those Arrow Academies just flooded out. I got all those in like a month, dude. It's crazy. So I'll check this out, and this release I'm super pumped for, because I actually love this film. I'm actually surprised that I got this. It is the Donnie Darko collection set, box set. I mean, this thing is dope as hell, guys. I love that cover, love Frank the Rabbit. I love this movie, it's fantastic. I've seen it a ton of times. I own like the 3 or 4 disc Blu-ray that was released years ago by Universal or Warner Brothers or whoever the hell owned the rights, I don't even know. But yeah, Arrow, this is a weird title for Arrow the release. I really wasn't expecting this, but Donnie Darko is the shit, so I can't wait to check that out. And then these next couple here are for Via Vision Home Entertainment. We have Cube. I recently did a review on this. I absolutely love this film. This is region free for anybody who is curious. You can pick this up on Via Vision's website. As well, guys, is Walmart.com actually carries these. So that's pretty interesting. After that, we have Cube Zero. This one, not as good as Cube, but I still did enjoy it very much. Same thing, Via Vision released this. And then Via Vision released this as well. I did a review on this too. The Fly Collection. This was really fun. I really much enjoyed watching all these films. This is region-free as well. You can also get this on Walmart.com. But it has all 5 Fly films. So you're talking The Fly, Return of the Fly, The Curse of the Fly, The Fly, and The Fly 2. So if you're curious on them Fly films, definitely pick this up. This is a solid, solid release. Blu-rays look great. These next couple are from Umbrella Entertainment. And we have Drive in Delirium 6070s. I did a review on this. Just a trailer compilation. It's really cool, guys. They have tons of trailers from the 60s and 70s on here. Really made me want to see more 60s and 70s films, because they're just so cool looking. And then we have Drive in Delirium Maximum 80s Overdrive, which is trailers from the 80s. Cult, action, horror, kung fu, all kind of different stuff on here. Really, really neat stuff. I absolutely love these trailer compilations. And they're super long, perfect for a party. What a cool release. And then we have Electric Boogaloo and Machete Maidens. I just got this in the mail recently, so I haven't had a chance to watch it yet. I've already seen Electric Boogaloo, and I actually really, really like it, but I have not seen Machete Maidens yet, so I'll check those out, the Machete Maidens, really quick, and do a review on it. And then we have Eyes of My Mother. A lot of people have been talking about this film. It kind of slipped my mind to watch this one. It was on the bottom of the stack, and you know, covered in all those arrows and stuff, so haven't watched this one yet. And finally for this update, sorry guys, my mouth is so dry. We have the Phantasm Collection, courtesy of Well Go USA Entertainment. They recently sent me a copy of this. I did do a review on it, which is doing fantastic, by the way. Hundreds of views, which I'm very happy about, because this is a release that I want a lot of people to see. It's such a great release. Like, it is, I love this thing to death. I love this thing. Highly recommend picking this up, guys. And then finally, we have the House Collection. That's right, not the House Story 1 and 2, but we have the House box set from the UK. This is House, House 2, House 3, and House 4. House 3, aka The Horror Show. And I actually bought this, guys. because I wanted all four House films. I thought it was such a cool release, and it turns out it is region free, so get them while they are still available. This thing's going to go out of print very quickly. I believe Arrow has already sold out their stock, so it's only available on Amazon and a few other retailers. But I highly recommend grabbing this set because it's going to go out of print. I can't wait to crack these babies open. It's either this tonight or Dead or Alive. So yeah, that's the update, guys. Thank you for watching. I'm so sorry that I rambled a little bit, but I'm tired and this video is long. So peace, bro.